Hello everyone, in this presentation we are going to learn about the identification of transformants or recombinants. But before going in more details, let us understand what do you mean by a transformant or a recombinant. In biotechnology, a transformant or a recombinant cell means a cell which has taken up a foreign DNA. In the previous lectures, we have already learnt about the making of recombinant DNA and transformation. The steps involved were isolation of DNA from the donor cell. The second step was fragmentation. In this step, what we do is we cut the DNA with the help of restriction enzymes. The third step was screening. In this step, we isolate the gene of interest. The next step is isolation of plasmid. Now, if we look at this plasmid, for example, PBR322, we are able to see that there are two antibiotic resistance genes. First one is ampicillin resistance gene, and the second one is tetracycline resistance gene. Now, within this antibiotic resistance genes, there are various restriction sites. For example, ampicillin resistance gene contain restriction sites for PVU1 and PST1, right? Whereas tetracycline resistant gene contains restriction site for BAMH1 and SALL1. Now, for example, if we use the restriction enzyme BAMH1, it will cut plasmid within tetracycline resistant gene. Fine. The next step is cutting of plasmid vector with the help of restriction enzyme. So as we already discussed, we have used BAMH1 for cutting the plasmid vector. So it will disrupt the tetracycline resistance gene. The next step is formation of recombinant DNA. In this step, what we do is we join our gene of interest with the cut plasmid. The enzyme used is ligase. Then the next step is transformation. In this step, what we do is we transfer the recombinant DNA into the host cell. Now, there would be three types of cell present in the bacterial culture. The first one would be a cell which does not contain any kind of plasmid. The second type of cell would be a cell which contains plasmid but no gene of interest. The third type of cell would be a cell which contains plasmid as well as our gene of interest. Right? But how to differentiate between these cells? How to identify a recombinant cell? So the next step is identification of recombinants. In this step, what we do is we grow bacterial cells on the medium containing ampicillin. Now, the first type of cells won't grow on this medium. Why? It is because these cells does not contain any kind of plasmid, which provides resistance against ampicillin. The second and third type of cells would grow on this medium. Why? Because they contain ampicillin resistant gene. But the question still remains, how to differentiate between these two cells? So for this purpose, we use a technique which is known as replica plating. In this technique, what we do is we use a sterile muslin cloth which is wrapped around a stamp. Now, this sterile muslin cloth is pressed on the master plate, because of which the colonies are imprinted on the muslin cloth. So we have the imprints of the colonies. Of the master plate. Fine. Now, this muslin cloth is then pressed on the medium which contain tetracycline. Fine. After incubation, we will have colonies grown on this medium. Okay. So, now when we compare this master plate, that is this master plate, with our replica plate, we can see that there are two colonies missing. Now, why these two colonies are missing? It is because these colonies are sensitive to tetracycline antibiotic. Why? Because we have inserted our gene of interest within the sequence of tetracycline resistance gene. So, these are the colonies which contain our gene of interest. So, now these colonies are then cultured. So, this is how we identify recombinants from the non-recombinants. This was all about the identification of transformants. If you have liked this video, please subscribe our channel. Thank you.